All the cheap cars. song about a very young man whose name was then and is now Ozzy Osbourne. Their utterance in the song, hurries that event along a little bit. But I like the moment in which they feel pretty good about their chances. This is called Clemency for the Wizard King. Thank you. go free. Thank you. very real with you about this, right? It's a terrible idea. Could be an appalling choice on my part. But I've registered your vote. I suspect there's several people like this song in this room. Top half's got the obscurities and stuff people didn't expect to hear. December. If you ever worked the headhouse of a grain elevator in December, man, in Iowa, it gets very cold. You want to stay in the office part of it, you know, working on song lyrics and stuff. Thinking about the state of Florida, the great state of Florida where it's warm. All right, man, the song goes like this. It's a D, an E minor with a B at it, right? I call it the Mountain Goats E minor. And then when it erupts to its climax, you'll be stunned to learn that it goes to G. The title is a bad pun because it's a type of mango we couldn't get in Iowa called Alphonse mangoes. This is called the Alphonse Mambo. Thank you. try to keep it sexy.
Lights and crackling emerald, signal hot and hot, fastest in production as of 1985. Never thought we'd ever come to dread that engine's roar. But she knew long before we did. Nobody will ever know for certain the names of all the secrets she held back behind the curtain. Jenny came to get me. She'd been gone for several years. Aging motorcycles, pearly cats, when they go near. And I was crying. I could barely make the frame out of my tears. She did, long before we did. She did, long before we did. Jenny, you did, long before I did.
Cheetah Rivera died today, I don't know if you heard. One of the greatest to ever stand on a stage. And one of the greatest clips you will ever see on the internet is of Cheetah Rivera surprising Liza Minnelli on some daytime talk show in the 70s by coming out to sing Nowadays. Right? And, it's one of the most joyous things you'll ever see. So for Cheetah, this is called Liza for Everyone.
There's the part you've braced yourself against, and then there's the other part. Still up inclining northward streets with some weird sickness in the dark. Saw your name on the sidewalk, I saw your brave face in my mind. If you're gonna sit next to the dealer, bed blind. Never get away, never get away. I'm never ever gonna get away from this place. Lay down on the streets, my eyes toward the sun, your star next to my face. The compasses I came into this world with never really worked so good. Gentle shadows spilling down the hills up on Mulholland and Ledgewood. Turn back, find someone to tell your secrets to. Catch me dreaming past an old hotel on Ivor. Seconds later, I saw you. Let the camera track me here. me set aside an hour or two in memory of sweet things. Regrind the lens again and again and again and again and again and again, and still the picture flips. Anyone here mentions Hotel California dies before the first line clears his lips.
Thank you so much. I gotta find my chord chart because, to be quite honest with you, this song has a lot of chords in it. Yo, yeah.
That's right, don't you go. Yeah.
So this is a song, oh man, I sort of feel like, I grew up in California, and I feel like, thank you, but I feel like when I describe the thing that inspired this song, the brief vision I had in 1986, I feel like people who aren't from the West Coast don't quite grasp the vibe, right? They can get it because we've all been in cars, right? But the thing is, on the West Coast, you're in your car a lot, right? And so you sort of, by the time you're 18, you're kind of, it's an extension of your body, you know? And you feel safe in it, generally speaking, right? It's like you have air conditioning, the windows are up, you know, and you feel pretty good about it. And so I'm working the shipping desk of the Los Angeles County Library system. I'm doing this thing where, like, you request a book, you want a copy of, I don't know, Geoffrey of Monmouth, right? History of the Kings of Britain, but they don't have it. They don't, you're in La Puente, they don't have it in La Puente, but they do have it in Duarte, right? So Duarte sends it to me, and I put it in a box, I send it to La Puente, right? I do this as what I did every day, just move these books around, right? From 8:30, thank you very much, I appreciate that. I also ran the copy machine and the mimeograph machine, I mean. And I made the coffee every morning, thereby smashing the gender binary single-handedly. So I would get off work at 4:30, at 5, and this is at West Covina, and I lived in Claremont. It's about, you know what song I'm talking about. So, and I would drive down to the Pacific to get on the 10, I think, and one day, there I am in traffic. This is your daily grind, right? You do it almost mindlessly. You drive here, turn left, get ready, listen to the radio. It's 5 o'clock funnies, whatever. So, and I looked over, I felt an energy sort of emanating from a car next to me. There's two lanes about to turn onto the freeway, right? I can attest, when you move to the East Coast, there are not two lanes turning on the freeway, there's just the one. I know, right? But there's the two lanes. Like, one car over here, you know, we've both pulled up to the stoplight, and I can feel an energy emanating. It's not the sound of the stereo, it's just an energy, right? And I become aware, I'm trying to stare, although I personally, with voyeur tendencies, I'll stare a little, I don't care. We're not going to be in this traffic forever anyway. So there's like four people about my age, maybe a year older. I'm 19 at this point, and I can see that, you know, both in the style of car, but also, you know, flashes of blonde highlights, that they have feathered hair, you know, down to about the shoulders, very, very, very sort of front row of the Journey concert kind of vibe. And it was three young women and a dude. The dude was driving, and they're all kind of laughing and talking, and I can sense as I look over, I, you know, maybe I didn't stare, but I turned my head to the right, And the driver, the young man with the feathered hair, maybe a roach clip in it, turned his head to the left and he smiled broadly. And my God will attest to this. He had fangs. Not kind of sharp incisors that you might confuse with fangs. Fangs. And then the light turned green and we both got on the freeway and I never saw him again. This is about that young man and his car, and it's called The Great King and the Silver Flame of Tune. In the secret caverns underneath West Covina, half desperate for peace, with the surface dwellers, but coming to no conclusions. And now we emerge, sky gray and misty. Grey King in his new Pontiac. Some of us sworn to the effort, trying to get our shapes back. Teeth filed down to fine points. Framework too tight. Strain of the joints.
Rail, sparks flying, You guys are amazing. Thank you. Die in here.
Thank you.
but they come and pull me from my house. And they drag my body through the streets. The sun's so hot, I think I'll catch fire. And I will burn up in the summer air, so moist and sweet. And the people all come out to cheer. Rocks on the pathway break my skin.
Position that you're magnificent silhouette. How much better? How much better?
so much.
You are a special audience, and I will remember you for a long time. And
but also,
you know, I'm from the West Coast. I feel there's energies that move that can't be defined and stuff. And like, I thank the club also because like an energy like this doesn't happen in any room. It has to be a collective thing. So. I've been working on that line delivery for 6 years. I'm reasonably certain this is the second time we've ever played Las Vegas, and I didn't really know what to expect. So special, we're talking about it every day. It's really this amazing package. Alicia and Bully, so good. Craig, one of the best lyricists of our generation. This work I have loved for a very long time. It's just a real pleasure to be out here sharing this music with you. That's why I'd like to throw you a curveball now. I sing for you a song of hope. There's one thing the Mongols are known for. It's hope. People say that, you know, there's interviewers say, well, there's always that kernel of optimism in your song. I go, well, technically yes, but.
May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. I hope when one door closes, you see one more open. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice, to sit it out or dance.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Beneath the roadway, I hope we can run past the last exit.
We haven't actually tried this without the full band before. Most bands have planned encores, and we don't. That's the thing with us. So, and the thing is, there's a song or two you can probably bank on hearing the encore. Right? We're not stupid. But at the same time, you want it to have some element that belongs to the city that gave us the pleasure of the show, right? So, so I just had a thought, and I said, "Hey, Matt, can you play this?" And he said, "Well, try." So.
Just a way to walk. Forgive us, Lord.
who's about to get three songs they were hoping the Mountain Goats would play tonight. There's bound to be a ghost at the back of your closet. No matter where you live, there'll always be a few things, maybe there will be several things, that you're gonna find really difficult to forgive.
Good. like a dog, down on the cards, spreading the spotlight, sweating real hard. All soaked in blood, like a newborn babe, sharp thing hit it in my hand, shaped like an astrolabe. I'm gonna stab you in the eye with a foreign object. I'm gonna walk right up and stab you in the eye with a foreign object.
Second year, the sea gets bad, the as you might imagine. And I can't
Thanks to Alicia and Craig for doing special that I've toured to all of you. See you next time.